John Harrington from Proactive Investors is with me. John, morning. Nice to see you.
Good morning. Good to be here.
We've seen the demise this morning of Monarch Airlines. Took many by surprise. An announcement made at 4 a.m. Some people on their way to the airport. Others had even checked in.
Yeah, I understand some people had checked in, but were not allowed to board, which must have been a source of frustration for them. But I suppose that it's not that much of a surprise in a way. They almost went bust last year. And for various reasons, which I'll maybe get onto later on. But last year, the Civil Aviation Authority kind of set up a shadow airline, same number of planes flying to the same destinations as Monarch, because it thought it would have to do this big repatriation exercise. For some reason, they didn't do it this year, and it's actually happened this year. So the government has asked the Civil Aviation Authority to kind of get hold of about 30 planes and eventually bring all these people home.
I think one of those that's been called upon is Qatar Airways. Is that right?
I don't know. Is that what Qatar, where the World Cup's being held?
I think a few of those have been brought over.
I would imagine that the airlines will like rally around in any spare planes they got, because it's not good for the industry to have people although some of us wouldn't mind spending an extra few days on the beach, but maybe not if you're holidaying in freezing Helsinki or something. You might be quite keen to come home, but.
Just to build on what you were saying, it really is a tough time in the industry, especially those servicing Europe recent terror attacks, weaker pound.
That's one of the things that's done for Monarch. I think obviously they've got the low cost, the no frills operators have moved into that what they call the short haul market to Europe, which is kind of is not the meat and drink. It was the whole of the business of Monarch. To a certain extent, people could book Monarch Airlines, but they also had this business of chartering out their flights to the package tour companies. So yeah, the terror attacks won't have helped them. They take most of their revenue in sterling, but a lot of their costs are in euros and the dollar. So when the sterling slumped after the Brexit, that would have really hit them hard. I think in 2015, although they mainly do Europe, they also fly to Egypt, and there was a ban on flights to Egypt. So that kind of hurt them as well. And like I said, last year they almost went under. The private equity company behind them stumped up some money and kind of recapitalized them. And we thought, hoping, fingers crossed, that they were going to survive and maybe benefit from the investing money in new planes and such like and change the model slightly. But obviously that's not panned out.
No, it hasn't. Of course, Ryanair, they've been in the headlines recently. They've had to cancel a number of their own flights to bring some of their costs down. They haven't been hugely popular, but their shares up among some others this morning on the back of this news.
It's a harsh world, or it's the old saying, it's an ill wind that blows nobody any good. And so while we've got 110,000 holidaymakers stranded abroad, which is obviously going to hit the headlines on the news tonight, A, it's taken the heat off Ryanair. B, it's a competitor that's disappeared, so that's more passengers available in future for Ryanair, EasyJet, Wizz Air, even British Airways to a certain extent. Plus, I think the market is hoping that they will be able to pick up some of the landing slots that Monarch have. I think they operate out of 5 airports, so those slots will become available. In Ryanair's case, they might be picking up some pilots that are desperate for a job. And
not just pilots.
Not just pilots, but staff that are happy to work under the interesting conditions that they have to work on Ryanair. And obviously been a benefit for the other quoted London airline companies. EasyJet and IAG are both up a couple of percent this morning.
Very nice to see you, John. Thank you.
My pleasure.